in Christ Jesus. And I pray that this forum creates the opportunity for your mind to be renewed in Christ Jesus. Stay in the fight, my brothers and sisters. We're going to Psalms 55, 1 to 2, and then we're going to jump down to 16 to 23 in the New Living Translation, Psalm 55. God spoke this scripture to me into my hearing. It was something that I needed, and I pray that that need is distributed evenly to the body of believers on today. Listen to my prayer, O God. Do not ignore my cry for help. Please listen and answer me, for I am overwhelmed by my troubles. But I will call on God, and the Lord will rescue me. Morning, noon, and night, I cry out in my distress, and the Lord hears my voice. He ransoms me and keeps me safe from the battle waged against me, though many still oppose me. God, who has ruled forever, will hear me and humble me and humble them. I'm sorry, let me read that again. God, who has ruled forever, will hear me and humble them. For my enemies refuse to change their ways. They do not fear God. As for my companion, he betrayed his friends. He broke his promises. His words are as smooth as butter, but in his heart is war. His words are as soothing as lotion, but underneath are daggers. Give your burdens to the Lord, and he will take care of you. He will not permit the godly to slip and fall. But you, O God, will send the wicked down to the pit of destruction. Murderers and liars will die young, but I am trusting you to save me. The term bottleneck is used to describe as a point of congestion or blockage. As disciples of Christ, we are commanded to make disciples. Jesus recruited the disciples, invested in them, and then sent them out to do the work. But when people are controlled, they never develop. We stunt growth when we don't prepare for expansion. When life overwhelms us to the point we can't see progress, it's a bottleneck. We are suffocated by the expectations of family members when we don't allow others to establish their own relationship with God. We create hindrance. We can even turn people away from God's word because we are looking for a following instead of wanting to see people delivered and set free. That is a bottleneck. The Holy Spirit spoke to me this morning, and he said, an expansion is getting ready to occur in our lives, and we have to remove these bottlenecks. Things that are creating congestion or blockage from us fulfilling purpose. Let's take inventory on today. Are we becoming spiritually obese, where we're not producing warriors for the kingdom? Spiritually stagnant? Are we stuck in a rut, dealing with the same conflicts over and over and over again, year after year? Or are we spiritually deformed? Is our relationship with God still in its infant stages and we should be on meat instead of milk? If we personally take inventory and answer yes to these questions, we won't expand. We won't get to see purpose. We have to recognize areas in our lives that create a bottleneck. A physical blockage, for example, can lead to kidney damage, kidney stones, and infection. Imagine what kind of hindrance is happening in our lives when we are being blocked spiritually. So today's war cry focus is remove every bottleneck in our lives. Remove every bottleneck. God, you said we have not because we ask not. And so we're coming to you, Father God, recognizing that there may be blockages, God, in our lives. There may be areas in our life where there's congestion, Daddy God. Congestion, there's things that are not getting through to us, God. You're speaking, but we're not listening, God. We're probably doing all the talking, so we're asking you, God, and maybe we're so distracted with the things of this world, Father God, because there's so much going on. Maybe we have to turn the TV off, or maybe we need to stop speaking to an individual that we can hear clearly what you have for us, God. Some of us are overwhelmed with pressures of life, God. There's things happening in every area of our lives because maybe we're trying to control it, Daddy God. Maybe we're trying to put our hands on things that we have to let go of, God, and that we can focus on what you called us to do, our purpose, God. Maybe, God, someone is pulling at us in every direction and being and we're having a codependent relationship, and we're not able to enjoy, God, what you have given us. We're not able to focus on our purposes. And so we're coming to you, thanking you for another day. Thank you for giving us breath of life. Thanking you for giving us wisdom. Thanking you for giving us this word to inspire us, God. This word that's going to create in us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within us, God. God, we desire you, God. But God, sometimes life can overwhelm us, God. Sometimes life can interfere with purpose, God. And Father, we want to be purpose driven. We want to be focused that when we get to you, God, when we get to that day at the doors or the doorsteps of heaven, you could say, good job, good job, my faithful servant, Father God. Well done, Father God, is what we want to hear. We don't want to be preoccupied, Father God, with all these things that don't, Father God, relate to purpose, God. We want, Father God, to be strategic about our purpose. We want to build and make disciples of men, Father God. We want to do your work, God, but we have, Father God, caused bottlenecks in our lives. We have caused bottlenecks. The way we think has caused us to be stagnated, God, in the name of Jesus. We're not growing spiritually because of some areas of our lives that we're holding and clinging on to, God. And we're asking you today to reveal it to your people, God. Show them, Father God, areas that they are creating, Father God, bottlenecks, God. And Father God, as we identify those bottlenecks, God, as we recognize those bottlenecks, God, we're asking that you give us the power by the Holy Ghost to remove those bottlenecks. If it's a thing, if it's a person, is it watching too much television, Father God? Is it focusing too much on social media, God? What is it that's hindering us, God? Is it a relationship that we're holding on to and you want us to let go of, God? Is it an image that we're holding on to, God, in the name of Jesus, that's causing us to be stagnated, God, in the name of Jesus, God, that we're not fulfilling purpose, God, that we're not reaching for that which you have called and orchestrated for us, God. We don't want to be like the crabs in the barrel, Father God, pulling people down, God, because we want to be somewhere that we think we should be, God. Oh, God, we're asking you to give us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within us, Daddy God. Show us the way. Show us truth, God. Give us wisdom, Father God. Oh, God, we're listening to you today, God. We want to hear what you have to say on today, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Oh, God, by the blood and the power of Jesus, we're asking you to break those bottlenecks, God. Remove those things that are clogging our spiritual growth, God. God, only you can do it. Only by the power of the Holy Ghost can you equip us, God, and prepare us, God, to do your will, God. At the same time, God, help us not to hold ourselves back, God. Oh, God, I hear you saying, well, sister had prayed one day on the prayer line. She said we self-sabotage our assignment, God. And we're asking you today to help us recognize if we're self-sabotaging certain areas of our lives, God. We're asking you to help us, God, with the lack of motivation, God, with the lack of purpose, with the lack of joy, God. Some of us are angry, God, all the time, looking for something to make us upset, God, in the name of Jesus, instead of looking at your blessings, God. And we're show us your blessings, God. Even in the midst of sorrow, even though we weep, God, joy cometh in the morning, God. We got to find purpose in the midst of a hard situation, Father God. I'm so encouraged today, Father God. I'm so encouraged by a sister who lost her son, who had purpose, God, who was full of life, God, even in the midst of her sorrow, God. And so we're asking you today, Father God, help us. Let that be said of us, God. Let that be said when people come into our presence, God, that we're full, Father God, of the joy of the Lord, full of hope, full of salvation, Father God. And I'm asking you, God, in our characteristics that are not of you, Father God, we're asking you to give us a renewing of the mind, God. Help us, Father God. Help us with those things that restrict us from growing. Oh, God, touch us, God. When you put someone on our hearts, God, help us to do what you called us to do, Father God. Help us not to be lazy about moving in purpose, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Help us, God, not to be full of the things of this world and seeking material things, God, but help us today, God, help us to remove spiritual obesity. How we're full of the word, Father God, but we're not giving it to nobody else. We're not giving hope, God. We're giving condemnation and judgment to others, God. We're not giving someone restoration in life, God. We're not providing that spiritual CPR and resuscitation on someone, Father God, who is about to die spiritually, Father God. Father God, remove the blockage. Remove the spirit of control, God. Remove the spirit of legalism and religious, God. Oh, God, who are we helping, God? Who are we helping to see the prize of God? Who are we helping to get to that destiny, God? Are we pulling people down, God? Are we being like a crab in the barrel, God, in the name of Jesus? It's time out for that, God. It's time out for that. People are hurting, God. People are hurting beyond what we could ever imagine, God. People are weeping, God, and we don't have time to be superficial and fake it, God, till we make it, God. We got to be transparent and real and vulnerable, Father God, because, Father God, so many are dropping before us, God, in the name of Jesus. We don't have time to waste, God, in the name of Jesus, with all these blockages that are hindering progress, God. Oh, God, we're just asking you to heal the sick on today, those that are going for surgery, God. I'm asking you to deliver them, Father God. I'm asking you to send forth your healing power, Father God, in the name of Jesus. I'm asking for the supernatural to happen, God. God, we haven't seen the supernatural. We haven't seen a Lazarus rise from the dead, God. We haven't seen the blind open up their eyes, God. And we're asking for a supernatural anointing over your body of believers today, Father God. As we get rid of these things that block, Father God, our spiritual growth, God, we're asking you today, Father God, that you would give us the power to pray somebody to healing, God. Pray like never before, God, that when we pray, Father God, things are moved, God. The foundations of the earth are shaken, God, in the name of Jesus. We need the supernatural in the end times, God. We need the power of Elijah on the end times, God. We need an anointing like Isaiah, God, and to see visions, God. Oh, God, we need your spirit like never before, God. So remove the blockages, God. Remove whatever is causing us, God, to be clogged, God, in the name of Jesus. Remove the distractions, God. Remove the hurts and pains that kept us from doing what you called us to do. Oh, God, remove the things from the past, God. Just remove them, God, today, God. God, we're trusting you, God. We're trusting you to make it happen for us, God. For make it that we can be disciples for you, God. That we can show forth your glory on this earth, God. Oh, God, that we can hear those words. Well done, my good and faithful servant. Oh, God, we just want to serve you, Father God. And we're just asking you to show us those areas in our lives, God, that need attention, that we can start working with you to remove the blockages. Hallelujah to your name, Father. All glory and honor belongs to you, God. God, we just thank you, God. We thank you for an opportunity to confess our faults before you. And we thank you for washing us today. It's in Jesus' name we do pray. Amen and amen.